it's of course it's different than being a Jew in even other places in Ukraine because of the history of Odesa. It's I wouldn't say that it's complicated. It was complicated, but it's a different type of complexity. It's for me personally, everything about the history, about the past, because the first Jewish pogrom took place in Odesa in 19th century, first official recorded Jewish pogrom. So it's dealing with complexity, and it's a sort of understanding of not only a history, but also a privilege. Privilege of being an outsider, being a minority. It's sounds absurdic, but it's also, if you look to that as a privilege, you can realize more deeply the whole reality. It's also a very, very complex question, because you can start from the literature, which is very important, and language, and Yiddish in Odesa, or Hebrew in Odesa. You can start from the music, you can start from the even architecture, because it was so many synagogues, and it was so many houses that was built by Jewish people, and it's an incredible architecture. So the spirit, I think, it's in a sort of combination of all that things. It's also difficult to speak about the spirit because it's difficult to define from the people. And the process of movement of the people, immigration, all the pogroms and all the Soviet repression, everything that happens in the past, somehow it's influenced the spirit of the city. And now it's difficult to find the sort of original spirit. I think it's my passion into music comes from the understanding of the music as a very general but very understandable language, language of communication, language of expressions, language of sharing. And it's very easy to understand. You hear the music and you immediately get some emotions. It can be a wedding music where you're celebrating and when you're partying and everything, but it also can be a very incredibly sad songs about all the tragedies. So through the music, you can feel and you can understand the whole complexity of the situation. And of course, Odesa music, it's incredibly interesting and important for the whole klezmer movement, because a lot of the songs came from the Odesa streets, Odesa backyards, where people played that music. And because of the presence of different minorities in the city, music was mixed. I don't like this term multicultural, but it's a good definition of the Odesa reality. So it's really a very multicultural city. Romanians, Italians, Roma people, Greeks, French. It was always present in the city because city was built by people who came there. It was originally a former Ottoman Empire castle called Hadjibey. But then a lot of Jewish people came, a lot of Greek people came. And this was a first wave of diasporas. And it was like a melting point in one specific period of time. Then after the Soviet Revolution, it's somehow collapsed. And it's become less diverse than it was before, of course. And after the Second World War, you can see only the traces of this diasporas or minorities who lived in the city before. I think, of course, yes, I understand myself and percept myself as a part of Odessa diaspora because I grew up there, and the works, the body of works that I'm doing, they're mostly grows from my background being in Odessa, being a Jew in Ukrainian Odessa. And it's a sort of undeniable fundament that you couldn't escape from. Last year, I did an exhibition with the Jewish Museum of Brussels, Jewish Museum of Belgium in Brussels. The exhibition was called Why Do You Stand at the Door? And exhibition was focused on the Jewish literature and specifically on the Jewish diaspora in Belgium. I did research in the museum, in the collection of the museum. The painter that I find in the collection of the Jewish Museum in Brussels, his name was Osip Sinyaevir. He was born more than 100 years ago, and I discovered that he was born on the same street where I was living. He has incredible biography because he immigrated to Belgium, he studied there, and he became known by his industrial landscapes. He paints mostly trains, coaches, and all the industrial infrastructure. And in the exhibition, I did a kind of an homage to his painting and replace one of his painting next to the videos that I filmed in Odessa. And the video was called As Far As Possible, and it's about the history of Odessa shore, Odessa salt lake called Kuyalnik.